Hello, my name is Blake within the Hyperloop. In this news pod, the main theme is collaboration. So let's get started. Heart Hyperloop, along with a number of other Hyperloop companies, including Zelleros, Hyperpoland, and Transpod, and the Union of Railways, all met in Europe and in Paris, in fact, to discuss collaboration with the EU Commission. We haven't seen as much details on this, and we certainly don't see as much of this in the United States. But this is really interesting, and we're glad that they're posting photos and updating everybody on possible collaboration in the future. Transpod also released this video, and it's the mobile transportation that's sustainable in the future. It's a really great 10-minute video. It's all in French. The target audience for this video happens to do with the Limoges area and their test track that is being built in the next couple years or so. And it's just a really fascinating video of who Transpod is, what their core technology is. Really good at explaining just what they're doing and why they're trying to do it. So I'd highly recommend, if you're a French speaker or have a lot of time to translate in Google Translate the subtitles, I'd highly recommend it. Next, Virgin Hyperloop One. They announced that they're taking part in the Dubai Expo 2020. Of course, they're going to have probably not a working Hyperloop at that, but they will have the passenger pods that they've also shown in other locations. And we really are excited that this will be an American entrant in the World's Fair. So that's really exciting. Next, Hyperpoland has released another video about their team, and they're currently seeking funding through a platform, and just a really interesting video of who they are, what they're trying to do, and where they're going from there. Finally, the SpaceX pod competition is happening. A lot of the teams have announced that they are through the second round of review process, so we're kind of in this final design or preliminary design briefing due, and then now everybody's working on their final design package. And I've seen a number of tweets that say that there's about 53 teams or 52, I'm not exactly sure, and we'll be doing more video information on that later. But stay in the loop and subscribe, and if you have any news tips or want to highlight what you're doing in the Hyperloop industry, please give us a ping. So until next time, bye-bye.